Salam, Nowruz Mubarak. So happy New Year, and I also thank you so much for this conference today we have about Sialk. And for me, it's a great day, not only to talk about Sialk and its archaeological significance, but also it's a good opportunity to make a further plan for archaeological research in Tappeh Sialk. And my doctor said to me not to go to UK because I am not well, but in my view, Sialk is important than my healthy. So I specifically thanks to Iran Heritage Foundation, Dr. John Curtis, and I just come just for you, because for your big effort for Iranian archaeology and Iranian history and Iranian civilization cannot be forget. And also is important Mr. Vahidi Nejat is here, because it's the first time after revolution we see our ambassador try to link UK university, UK research center with Iranian university, with Iranian cultural heritage organization. So this is so, so important for us, and to close a scholar together, to work together, for to make a peaceful life for future. I also should inform you that I wanted to talk about Sialk North and its archaeological significance, my joint work with my supervisor, Professor Robin Cunningham. But the problem was that our lecture was similar together. So this afternoon, Robin Cunningham will present our latest information about research work in Tappeh Sialk. And now I try to talk about Bolantar. So I talk about in general significance of Tappeh Sialk and Central Plateau, and in relation with the other part of Iran. Geographically, the Central Plateau of Iran covers the majority of Iran, but how did the process of normalization develop in this region? Archaeologically, are we in a position to propose a long, complex, and independent development trajectory for the origin of agriculture and animal domestication for the Iranian Central Plateau? What is the nature of archaeological evidence for the transition from the Epipaleolithic to the Neolithic period, and also from transitional Chalcolithic to the Bronze Age in this region? What is the nature of interregional interconnection of the Iranian Central Plateau with the other parts of Iran during the Chalcolithic and Bronze Age? By such question, I like to propose a long term of cultural development in the Central Plateau based on the diachronic and synchronic perspective. Since 1930, multiple archaeological investigations within the three ridge plains of Qazvin, Tehran, Qom, and Kashan have been conducted in order to study the origin of agriculture and development of social complexity in a diachronic and synchronic approaches. However, the new investigation from 1990 have tried and built a new chronology based on the settlement survey, stratigraphic excavation, cross-dating, seriation, and C14 results. Chronologically, nowhere in Iran cannot be compared with the North Central Plateau of, and the current data allows us to demonstrate a gradual cultural development of simple to more complex one from 6 to 3 million BC. Have you any pointer or not? If you can see the table, there are some most important Neolithic and Chalcolithic and Bronze Age sites which currently excavated during the past 20 years. Tappeh Charbune, Tappeh Ibrahimabad, Zaghe, Qabristan, Sags, Sagzabad, Shizar, Arisman, Sialk, South and North, and Tappeh Quli Darvish. In the yellow color, you can see Tappeh Sialk is only prehistoric site in Iran, in Central Plateau of Iran, covers the cultural sequence from 6000 BC and ended to the Iron Age period. So based in this model, you can see that I have divided the chronology of the region on the late Neolithic period, transitional Chalcolithic, and Chalcolithic period covers early, middle, and late Chalcolithic phases, and then the Proto-Elamite. So my talk goes from the late Neolithic, the current evidence we have about human society from 6000 BC, and I ended my lecture to the Bronze Age. The Neolithic period in Iran was a time of fundamental change in human relationships with the natural world, a reformation and intensification of human engagement with plant, animal, and the border and the broader environment, creating of farming and herding basis of all subsequent society in the region. Recent archaeological researches in the central Zagros represent the evidence of the transition from the Neolithicization way of life in the Neolithic farming society based on the full domestication spaces of and people live in the true village within the permanent life base. So in this table you can see, this is the most of site we have here from Sheikh Abad, which worked by Professor Roger Matthew and Hamadan University, demonstrate the earliest Neolithic life from 9600 BC, and then the gradual changes from the later period during Neolithic period, and the other side, and Johnny and the German and archaeological research team, Mohsen Zaidi, indicate the well definition of how the Neolithization process and occurred in Iran and parallelly with the Levant and the other area of Iran. It seems from the late 7 millennium BC, most part of Iran was occupied by Neolithic people, and therefore locally, we can assume people were migrated from central Zagros to the central plateau of Iran around 7200 BC afterward. Sialk North is a distinctive site in the central plateau of Iran to study the village life in the whole period of the 6 millennium BC. It has 14 meters of Neolithic cultural layers, and Sialk is the best example of the use of a space and building function of prehistoric villages of Iran. In 2008 and 2009, limited excavation, we could record a good sequence of cultural sequence from Sialk North from 6000 BC from the lower layer of the site here, which we talk more this afternoon, and indicate that the site started from 6000 BC and ended 4900 BC, and also very good sequence of radiocarbon date, and also some gap between the Sialk North 250 years, so we are here. But the whole site indicates 1,000 years of occupation in Sialk North for the 6 millennium BC. In spite of we have such good cultural layer, but about the economy of the earliest villager who came to Sialk. However, we are still too far to know the agricultural system of the Neolithic societies of the Iranian Central Plateau, and Margaret Temberg and Hengam Ilkhani studies for this period is still is in earlier stage, and very happy we have Dr. Margaret Temberg here and will explain a lot about this one, about the agricultural economy. However, based on the current information, it seems villages of Sialk cultivated of hulled emmer and hulled naked barley during the Neolithic time, while evidence of naked wheat bread and wheat type and lentil were found during the 5th millennium BC. This signals the economy of the farmer of the society of the central plateau different from the community of the southwestern of Iran. Carl Wittvogel, in his book Oriental Despoties, explained the development of ancient civilization with systematic organization of work on large scale. The emergence of social class and widespread specialization was elaborated by the historian and political scientist. Wittvogel believed that the development of irrigation work in Mesopotamia and Egypt led to the use of mass labor to an organizational hierarchy for coordinating and directing the activities, and the increasing governmental control for the ensuring power distribution of the water. But the economic system of the most part of Iran highland from 6 million BC to the recent time, mostly based on the small-scale agriculture and use of direct access of water in a population with maximum 2,000 people. Most of the Neolithic and Chalcolithic sites expanded less than 10 hectares, and sites such as Sialk North has been extended more than 3 hectares during the Neolithic period. Therefore, we should emphasize that the formation of the Iranian highland society in the central Iran was different from Mesopotamia, and we need an independent theoretical approaches for Iran. Both Grishman and Malek Shahmirzadi and our excavation represent the architectural layout of Sialk during the 6 millennium BC and early 5 millennium BC. It is important to mention both Grishman and 2008 and 9 excavation shows around 4 meters of cultural layer without any significant architecture, the lower layer of Tappeh Sialk, the earliest people of Sialk people. As Grishman assumed, this context revealed the villager of Sialk lived in the straw huts during the first half of the 6 millennium BC. By the time they made their house with mud brick, clay wall without any foundation and also a stone wall. They did not use mud plaster of the two surfaces of the wall. However, during the transitional Chalcolithic of 5 millennium BC, we faced with the lots of innovations such as using of sun-dried mud bricks with fingerprint on the surface. The house have mud brick foundation and both the internal and external wall covered with red plaster. In 2008 excavation, we found 2 meters of house's wall indicate.
Yeah.
And indicate that the highest wall were above the 2 meters and the deaths were buried inside the houses, primarily alongside with the wall. It is also interesting to mention that the villager of Sialk paved their houses with sun-dried mud brick wall during 6000 BC. So we hope by horizontal excavation of Tappeh Sialk North, we can recover the best example of house management and village life of the Iranian society during the Neolithic time. And also we have a nice plaster, mud brick plaster, so probably indicate some public and cultic center of Tappeh Sialk and needs more further excavation. And so I want to go to about the mortuary practice and burial custom of Tappeh Sialk North during the Neolithic period. Material culture associated with burial offers information concerning the role of power and ideology as reflected in social order. The mortuary evidence from Tappeh Sialk represents simple burial custom of grave inside the residential parts during the Neolithic period, which is also addressed no social ranking and offering of craft goods with the burial. In general, burial consists of single skeleton interred in the simple pit, offer dug under the floor of units and courtyards without to use cemetery. So people bury their deaths inside the village. During the 2009 excavation at Sialk North, we found the 6 burial. One was a double burial with both the cremated and uncremated human bone, which is the first example for the Middle East. We have some cremation during the Neolithic period in Sialk.
Although cremation is rare in all periods in Iran, as many as five examples were discovered at Tappeh Sialk North, the body of the adults were burned, whereas the body of the infant were both cremated and burned without burning, buried without burning. This symbolic system of burial custom display as mortuary ritual activities may be considered a form of ideology and cosmology of Nordic people of the Iranian Central Plateau. Back to the Kayuvin, in which he argues the primary factor of a new life during the Neolithic period with the emergence of new idea and new religious practices and new symbols from the Neolithic period onward. But such archaeological indicators which were found in Turkey and Levant in Iran is very rare and unclear for us. Unfortunately, we have no valuable data related to the cult and religion practices of village society of Iran, and it is truly needs long and large excavation operation on the to find public religious building. The only example now we found of a worship person excavated by Roman Grishman to be considered a form of ideology and cosmology of the Neolithic people of the Iranian Central Plateau. I know we have some example, sign of some example from Sheikh Abad by Professor Roger Matthew and Dr. Yaqub Mehdifar represent 9000 BC, but such evidence it needs more excavation and more work, and also Tappeh Sialk, I'm sure we can find much, much better evidence. Oh, maybe they were kafir and had no religion during the Neolithic. So I want to end with Neolithic and back to the Chalcolithic period. For North Central Iran, the term transitional Chalcolithic has been given a long time, a span almost a millennium, bringing the Neolithic to the Chalcolithic. From the end of the 6th millennium BC, we can trace the development of essentially the late Neolithic community to the more complex society of full-time Chalcolithic period. Indicators of this transition include intensified herding of cattle, sheep, and goat, and cultivation of barley and bread bed, employing irrigation system, the development of long-distance trade and exchange of material, increasing complex social activity, including social differentiation in mortuary practices, the use of a specialized craft area for increasing standard craft production, including early metallurgy and the use of the innovative production techniques such as mineral tempered and well-drawn pottery. The technological innovation that marked the start of the Chalcolithic of the North Central Iran, including a shift to calcareous clay for vegetal tempered clay, the use of the basic turning device, the use of the black rather than biochrome painted ceramic, which you can see, decoration, and increase of firing temperature to between 800 to 1,000 centigrade, which Professor Nokandi will explain about the pioneer innovation, how affected on the metallurgy of Iran after my talk. While the old data represent the Central Plateau was isolated and their context was regionally, but the new information indicate, the new information I emphasize about the past 10 years of research in Iran, in the Central Plateau, information indicate that the interconnection of the Central Plateau with the southwestern of Iran, the Fars region, you can see the ceramics of Qumrut, which much similar with the Fars region and the southwestern of Iran, and also the northwestern of Iran. As Abbas Alizadeh proposed, it is appears that the Susiana and the Fars region interacted to the Central Plateau from mid-5th millennium BC, specifically in the copper-rich area of the Iranian Central Plateau, was a main factor for such interaction. From this period, we have not the ceramic type of the above-mentioned region in the same part of the Central Plateau, but also the stamp seal from Qumrut, you can see it, of site of Qumrut, are similar with Shosha or Susa A, prized person. Flow of such information reveals that development of social inequality in transitional society of the North Central Plateau during the 5th millennium BC or 7,000 years ago, same as the Shusha or Susa late 5th millennium BC. Both Krishman Malik Shamirzadi and our new excavation indicate Sialk North was only occupied by a short period of the during the transitional calcolithic period within the 2 meters of cultural material start from 5,200 BC and end 4,900 BC. But even of this short time of occupation, the richness of the transitional calcolithic layers of Sialk is remarkable, specifically about the village layout and house construction. Although intramural practices considered during the calcolithic period continued during the Chalcolithic period, but in Sialk and many settlements, but the grave goods addresses the development of social inequality during the transitional Chalcolithic period. As I mentioned, during the Neolithic, we have no craft goods in the burial, but for the first time, we have some ceramic beads in the grave, which buried inside the village. Still, they don't have any cemetery. Burial with the village houses include adult male and female and children, many painted with red ochre and some modest numbers of ceramic vessel, stone cosmetic plaster were buried with the burial. Preliminary studies suggest that there is little match between the consumption of beads and local evidence of bead making activity during the transitional calcolithic. Now turn to the examine the last millennia of the calcolithic across the north central of Iran from 4300 BC with change both of material attribute of society and the underpinning socioeconomic structure. Certain key sites appear to increase in size and become important through the late 5th and early millennium BC, suggesting a degree of settlement hierarchy. Prime amongst these sites are Tappeh Sialk of the Kashan Plain, Gabrestan in the Ghazvan Plain, Cheshme Ali in the Tehran Plain, and Arisman in close to Kashan. So far, Tappeh Sialk is the only site in the central plateau is represent a whole sequence of the 4th millennium BC. To end allows shows continuity from the early Chalcolithic to the middle Chalcolithic, from middle Chalcolithic to the late Chalcolithic, and the start of the Bronze Age. And it is appearing a gap between 1,000 years between the early Bronze Age sequence between the late to the Iron Age period. The 4th millennium BC for the north central Iran can be characterized with the full-time specialization of copper and ceramic, large part of Chalcolithic site, such as Tappeh Gabrestan, Sialk, and Arisman, are specifically with large-scale production of metal production based on the alloying copper, socioeconomic interaction with Mesopotamia and southwestern Iran during the Uruk period, and finally the subject of the Iranian feature, beginning of the proto-Elamite writing system. A number of specific technological innovation in ceramic production are very characteristic of the middle Chalcolithic period, including the use of the wheel and firing of various ceramic vessels in large kiln. The majority of the middle Chalcolithic ceramics consist of fine painted pottery and crusted ware. The painted group can be subdivided into the three groups of very fine, and thick wall. The early Chalcolithic ceramics is remarkably by change from the black on red to black on buff ware during the late Chalcolithic period. Why this is so important? Because this ceramic type not only found in the many central plateau sites, but also we have in the central Zagros and in the Azerbaijan area. Black on buff ware are distributed across the culture, the central and north central Iran, and the exception of northwest where we called chalk-faced indominant, suggesting concerning of the region with community across the southern Caucasia, eastern Turkey, and upper Mesopotamia. And Katrin Morrow and Barbara Helving has documented about how the society of the central plateau have been interconnected with the southern Caucasia and Azerbaijan and eastern Turkey. But in spite of have such good evidence, the main and missed information of the whole area of the north central Iran is that there is lack of data about the monumental building related to the first half of the first millennium and also the fourth millennium. Symmetry and also well data regarding of daily activities. Sialk shows with good cultural context of the fourth millennium data is one of the best example to record data related to the economic activity, house construction, and probably record monumental building and religious activity for the fourth millennium BC. And we know, Dr. Nokande explained, in spite of the 5 years of Dr. Malek Shahmirzadeh's work on Sialk, it is the early preliminary stage. We need more and more excavation to record about the other aspect of Central Plateau society. The economy of Iran also is one of the early hearthland of metallurgy and critical to investigate the origin and development of copper production in ancient Near East. Iran had central role in technological copper development by the indigenous society with major advantage of arsenical copper, silver, and gold production during the fourth millennium BC. The Middle Chalcolithic period is the best example of craft specialization and expansion of industrial part of many north central plateau of Iran, such as Sialk, Arisman, and Tabi Gabristan. Development of skills in metalworking is a major achievement of the full Chalcolithic period in Iran. Copper is the most significant metal in this process, but at the same time, initial experiment with working a gold, silver, and lead, and other material. So I'm very close to finish my lecture. Based on the radiocarbon date from several sites, it seems that Uruk period in the southwestern Iran started around 4000 BC and ended 3100 BC. The large similarity of material culture between Khuzestan, Lowland, and Lowland Mesopotamia Uruk period doesn't address the origin of the fourth millennium social complexity from Mesopotamia, but rather than Iran was rather a parallel development of Uruk period in Iran. One of the important issues is that around 3400 BC, the regional culture of Sialtri, you can see it's a beautiful ceramic, John Curtis showed it, and for the late Chalcolithic period, this is the missing link. One of the important issues is that around 3400 BC, the regional culture of Sialtri was ended suddenly. It is not exactly clear for us how and why such cultural complex was ended at the Uruk or Shushadu II period, without any continuation. Sites such as Sialk, Gabristan, Cheshme Ali, Arisman doesn't have a transitional layer and need further investigation. This is a mysterious aspect of the North Central Plateau society, and we truly need to have large operation excavation of sites such as Sialk, Sos, late Chalcolithic layers to understand how and when the local culture was ended and the society in the North Central was emerged, the new society emerged. As I mentioned earlier, the earliest material evidence pertaining to the central, cultural contact between lowland Susiana and the forest region of the highland central plateau back to the fifth millennium BC. This contact was gradually re-established during the 3400 BC, reaching its zenith during the initial phases of proto-Elamite 3200 BC. And proto-Elamite pottery and administrative technology appear one of the number of sites in the central plateau, such as Sialk, Uli Darvish, and Sufalin. And finally, unfortunately, the reconstruction project by Malik Shahmirzadi and Nukur Nokande on the proto-Alamite layer was stopped, and Barbara Helving worked on it. So they reached the site, the proto-Alamite layer, but they couldn't continue the excavation. So I am sure the problem of Shusha of proto-Alamite will be solved by excavation of Sialk source on the proto-Alamite layer. Thank you so much for your attention.